And welcome to this course on numerical methods, or also known as computational techniques. In the next couple of minutes, I will just go over the course plan that we'll have in this course. Okay. So let me recap the definition that I had given in the introduction lecture. Computational techniques or numerical methods use computers to solve problems through stepwise, repeated, and iterative solution methods. Now, what do we mean by repeated and iterative solution methods? Is that we start with one particular guess of the solution, okay, and then we use certain algorithm or certain procedure in an iterative manner and in a repeated manner in order to get to a desired solution. On the other hand, what we mean by stepwise is you start from one starting point and you have certain other end point to reach to, and you go from that starting point to the next point, then to the next point, then to the next point in step by step manner till you finally reach the end point. Okay. This is what would be meant by a stepwise procedure. So, most of the numerical methods that we are going to cover in this course are either stepwise or iterative solution methods. We will go over them briefly in the first module. After that, we will go over them in rest of the modules, rest of the 11 weeks, the weekly modules, and show how to use different types of approaches in order to solve these problems using numerical methods. What do you need for this course? For the lectures to be most effective, what I would recommend is that you work with me during the lectures. So, if I am solving a particular problem, you can always pause a video and solve that same problem along with me. For you to be able to do that, you need a pen and a notebook and a calculator. In the exams and assignments, the assignments and exams are going to be based on pen, paper and calculator only. Okay. However, in order to demonstrate the concepts, I will make use of Excel or Google Sheets. The reason why I do that is with pen and paper or calculator, you can solve relatively small size problems. If I really want to emphasize what happens when you have larger size problems or when you have to do certain things iteratively for a large number of iterations, how the results can be interpreted and can be understood is something that I can demonstrate with Excel and Google Sheets. However, I reiterate again, all your assignments and exams, as well as certain tutorials that we will go through in this course, will be using pen and paper and a calculator. Okay. So, what you need is really a calculator to do this particular course, and that is the procedure that we are going to follow in this course. Okay. Layout of the course. The course is split, as I said, into 12 weeks. Each week is one module. That module focuses on one key concept. So, each module focuses on one key concept, and in each week we will go over motivation and an overview of that topic. We will take up certain examples. We will solve the example using an iterative or a stepwise or a direct procedure. We will also use graphical methods to get certain insights into the problem. We will do derivation and analysis and finish off that week with a summary. That is what we are going to follow in each of these 12 weeks. As I had mentioned earlier, that this is a repurposed course, which means that originally each lecture was about 1 hour long. I have then split those 1 hour lectures into 10 to 15 minute lectures, and therefore, I hope these will be very useful for you, that each lecture is going to then go over one micro concept, and you can then look at all the lectures in that particular week, and that will give you an overview of that key concept that is the focus of that week's. And these are the topics covered in the 12 weeks. We will start with introduction and computational error analysis. This next week, we are going to look at linear systems and linear equations. We will solve them using what is known as direct methods. In week 3, we will solve linear equations using iterative methods. Week 4 and 5 are algebraic equations. Week 6 is differentiation. Week 7 is integration. Week 8 is regression, also known as curve fitting. Week 9 is interpolation and curve fitting again. Week 10 and 11 is ODE initial value problem of ordinary differential equations initial value problem, and finally the last week is boundary value problems. So, this is the overview and the course plan that we have for rest of this 12 weeks. I hope you will gain most out of this course. Thanks and see you later. Bye.